In some situations, we use the particle model to study the motion of objects. A moving object can be considered as a particle when its dimensions are negligible compared with the length of its path. When a system cannot be considered as a particle, it is considered as a system of particles. The system of particles could be a group of particles such as a water molecules in a container or an extended object such as a swimmer. In order to study the position and the motion of a system of particles, we introduce the concept of the center of mass.
Consider an object consisting of two blocks connected by a thin rod. The object is thrown in air. The motion seems to be confusing. Observe the motion again. The red point represents the center of mass of the object. The object rotates around its center of mass, and the motion of the center of mass follows a parabola. In other words, we can treat the object as if all its mass were located at the center of mass and consider the force of gravity to be acting at the center of mass.
Now look at this vase. The mass of the vase is considered to be concentrated in this point, which is the center of mass of the vase. In general, the center of mass of a system of mass m is the point at which the whole mass of the system is considered to be concentrated. Let us consider a skater jumping in air and moving under the action of his weight. The skater's hands and legs move in different directions. However, the center of mass of the skater continues on the same curvy path since no change occurs in the net force acting on him. In general, the center of mass moves like a particle of mass m acted upon by the net external force on this system.
The center of mass of an object is not necessarily located on that object. Look at this rescue wheel. Its center of mass is not located on the rescue wheel. If a uniform object has an axis of symmetry, then its center of mass lies on this axis. Look at the vase. It has one axis of symmetry, and its center of mass lies on this axis. If a uniform object has two or more axes of symmetry, then its center of mass is at the intersection of these axes. Look at this object. It has two axes of symmetry. Its center of mass lies at the intersection of these two axes.
No. Let's give examples about the position of the center of mass of some uniform rigid objects. For a uniform thin rod, the center of mass coincides with its midpoint. For a uniform sphere, the center of mass coincides with its center. For a uniform thin rectangular plate, the center of mass coincides with the intersection of its diagonals.
For a thin triangular sheet, the center of mass is at the intersection of its medians or at the centroid. For a uniform cylinder, the center of mass lies at the axis of the cylinder and on the midpoint of its height.
Focus, please. This is important.
The position of the center of mass of a system depends on the shape of this system and on the way its mass is distributed in the system. Consider a system lying in the XY plane and consisting of n particles, such that the first particle has a mass m1 and a position vector r1. The second particle has a mass m2 and a position vector r2 until the nth particle, which has a mass mn and a position vector rn. Let's see m be the center of mass of this system. So, the position of the center of mass of this system is given by this formula, which is the vector sum of the mass of each particle multiplied by its position vector over the total mass of the system. But the total mass of the system can be denoted by m. So, the abscissa of the center of mass of the system is given by this formula. x1 is the abscissa of the first particle, x2 is the abscissa of the second particle, and xn is the abscissa of the nth particle. Similarly, the ordinate of the center of mass is given by this formula. y1 is the ordinate of the first particle, y2 is the ordinate of the second particle, and yn is the ordinate of the nth particle. If the particles of the system spread out in three dimensions, we need to specify also the z component of the center of mass. So zcm becomes m1z1 plus m2z2 plus mnzn over the total mass of the system.
Let's solve an application about finding the position of the center of mass. Consider a system consisting of three particles A, B, and C. The system is placed in the XY plane. The mass of A is 2 kilograms, the mass of B is 0.5 kilograms, and the mass of C is 1 kilogram. Before finding the position of the center of mass, we need to find the coordinates of each particle. These are the coordinates of particle A. These are the coordinates of particle B. And these are the coordinates of particle C. Now, to determine the abscissa of the center of mass, we use this equation. Replace xA by 2, xB by minus 1, and xC by minus 1. You will get the abscissa of the center of mass is 0.71 meters. Let's move to the ordinate of the center of mass. Replace yA by 2 meters, yB by 3 meters, and yC by minus 1 meters. Then the ordinate of the center of mass is 1.3 meters. Then these are the coordinates of the center of mass. And look at the position of the center of mass on the figure.
We add a particle D to the system. The mass of particle D equals 3 kilograms. XD and YD are the coordinates of particle D. The center of mass of the new system, composed of A, B, C, and D, coincides with the origin O of the XY plane. Determine XD and YD of the particle D. The abscissa of the center of mass of the new system is given by this equation. Replace each physical quantity by its value, therefore, XD equals minus 0.83 meters. Similarly, the ordinate of the center of mass of the new system is given by this equation. Replace each physical quantity by its value, then the ordinate of particle D equals minus 1.5 meters. Therefore, the coordinates of particle D equals minus 0.83 meters minus 1.5 meters.